You're watching update 3 of Cyclone Lam, currently with winds of 80 miles per hour and a pressure of 970 millibars. The storm's been intensifying. Its position's 10.9 degrees south, 136.4 degrees east at 2 p.m. UTC on February 18th, that's late evening in Australia. The storm is expected to intensify further, making landfall on the top end as a Category 2 storm. That's on the Saffir-Simpson-Hurricane wind scale. It could be up to Category 4 on the Australian scale. It already is a Category 3 storm on that scale. But storms expected to make landfall with sustained winds of 100 miles per hour or higher, to put it in absolute terms, and then move inland and gradually weaken and eventually dissipate in the next 4 days somewhere inland over the Northern Territories, or perhaps just about making it towards Western Australia. Of course, as you'd imagine, lots of warnings in effect at this time. Cyclone warning in effect from south of Cape Shield to east of Goulburn Island, and cyclone watch in effect for Port Roper to Croker Island, extending inland as far as Bulman, as well as the island of Groote Eylandt. And those warnings could extend further west as the storm moves inland, but probably not too far, as the storm is expected to weaken significantly and not affect much other areas than what we're already seeing covered in warnings at this time. And those are the latest warnings as of 2 p.m. UTC. Looking at the latest sea surface temperatures, you can see this storm and also the other storm, Marcia, that's formed in the past few hours. Cyclone Lam's the one on the left, over warm waters around 30 degrees at this time, so no wonder it's already a hurricane force cyclone. And that's likely to continue up until landfall and beyond. Wind shear is low as well towards the southwest, very low inland, and moderate to high towards its east and northeast and north, but probably won't be too much of a factor in this. So water vapour is significant as well, because very moist amounts of water vapour around the storm. Looking at latest floater imagery, you can see how the storm's been developing. You can possibly see perhaps the makings of an eye inside there as well, towards the centre of the storm there, quite a way north of any land area, but it's sort of become elongated, that central core, in the past few frames, extending towards land and towards the north as well, with a huge band towards the left-hand side of the storm affecting the area around Darwin and the other part of the Northern Territories. But the storm is expected to move overland, curving towards the south very soon indeed, before it gets that far west. As of February the 18th at 2 p.m. UTC, we currently have four systems active, two storms of course, Lam and Marcia, and the Invest 91S and 90S, still lingering over the South Indian Ocean, but not likely to develop. Of course, Lam and Marcia are the ones we are watching. An update on Marcia will be following very soon indeed, because we have warnings in effect there too. 11 storms have formed so far in 2015, 6 of those have become Category 1 hurricanes or their equivalents around the world, and 3 of those have become Category 3 storms with winds of 115 miles per hour plus. I wonder whether this storm will become the 4th. Not looking particularly likely at this time. It just seems that time will run out before the storm does make its landfall and land interaction gets in the way of any further development. You can follow Force 13 at any of its outlets. The website, of course, force13.com, is as always the main place to stay up to date for all the goings on around the world storm-wise. Of course, the video page for Force 13 on YouTube, and of course the social platforms. Search Force 13 on Facebook and Twitter, at Force 13 on the latter. You can also speak to me on Skype, at Fool13, for tropical weather chat on there, and you can ask for an invite to our chat room that we run on there as well, where you can get involved with other storm discussers to discuss the latest goings on and whatever else that we may be talking about. That's all for now. The next update on this storm will be at 2:30 a.m. UTC. That's on the 19th.